seasonal influenza is a problem for the elderly. It's a highly contagious disease anyway, but about 90% of all people dying from influenza are over 65. And that's the reason why we try to prevent this by vaccinating these people. But there's a problem, because the vaccine doesn't work as well in the elderly as it does in young adults. It has an only efficacy, protecting efficacy, of about 50% in the elderly. And that means that there's a lot to gain when we can improve the vaccine. And the question is, how can we do that? Well, there are some scientific investigations, and that have shown that the immune system of the elderly doesn't work as well as the immune system of younger people. And if we would understand the reason why it doesn't work as well, then we could improve this, and we may be able to fix the immune system and make it again capable to develop protection. And we and other people have done research in that field, the field of immunosenescence, that's the name for this phenomenon. And what we found is that there are several branches of the immune system that don't work as well as they should. But that means that there is no quick single solution to fix the immune system. And this research will continue, but the question, of course, is, can we do something on the short term? And luckily, the answer is yes. And there are actually three lines of approaches that have worked. You can increase the amount of antigen in the vaccine. That works. You can administer it in a different way, in the skin instead of in the muscles. And the final solution is to add an adjuvant, something that boosts the vaccine. And actually, the adjuvant MF59 has been most successful. And that has led to a licensed vaccine. And the other two approaches didn't lead to a licensed vaccine. But the drawback is that the licensed vaccine with MF59 is not used very much. So the conclusion is that there's still a problem, and there are solutions, but we have to do more to solve the problem. And the main problem is that the public health officials are waiting for industry, and the industry is waiting for public health people. And that has to be solved before we can continue.